Now I type tag from my phone and then the tag displayed at my serial monitor and my LCD using Bluetooth module. And I also try to turn on and off 3 LEDs from my phone using a Bluetooth module. Welcome back to Milium.com. In this video, we will learn how to use Bluetooth module with Arduino to send, receive data and also give commands to Arduino using Bluetooth from our phone. Now I have these two Bluetooth modules. These are HC-05 and SPP-C. Let's take a look closer to HC-05. So it has 6 pins and has TX and RX pins, means that this device uses serial communication. And the second one is SPP-C Bluetooth module. This is the newer version of HC-05, the replacement of HC-05. So it has 6 pins too, but only 4 pins have headers. And it's okay since only 4 pins that we need. These two Bluetooth exactly have the same way to use, so I will just use the SPP-C in this tutorial. You can use the same way to the HC-05 Bluetooth module. This means that you can use HC-05 too with this tutorial. Let's start the wiring diagram. As you can see, we have VCC to 5V, ground to ground, and I will connect the TX pin to pin 3 and RX pin to pin 4 of Arduino. When powered on, the LED at the Bluetooth module will blinking. This means that this Bluetooth module already powered but not connected to any device yet. Now the wiring is complete, let's start the Arduino IDE and start the code. This is the sketch to forward text from serial monitor to software serial, which is at pin 3 and 4. This means that the tag from serial monitor will be forwarded to Bluetooth module. Don't worry, you can copy this sketch from the link in the description below. Now upload the sketch to our Arduino. After the upload is complete, now we can test the communication between the Arduino and Bluetooth module. Don't forget to choose the both NL and CR and 9600 baud rate. This Bluetooth module is using AT command, just like the SIM card module that I have made many tutorials on that device in this channel. Just type AT and it should answer OK. Every time I type AT, the Bluetooth should answer OK. So communication is working well. If you don't receive the OK answer, double check the wiring. To see the Bluetooth name, you can type AT plus name. And we have answer plus name equals to milium.com. This means that my Bluetooth module name is milium.com. I already changed the default name so we have it. You can also see the baud rate by type 80 plus baud. 4 means 9600, and these are other numbers means. To see the pin or password for pairing, you can type 80 plus pin, and that's it. The pin is 1, 2, 3, 4. This is the default pin. To see the version, you can type 80 plus version, and that's the version of my Bluetooth module. Now, if you want to change the Bluetooth name, you can type 80 plus name and follow it by the name you want. For example, I type 80 plus name Tess. It will change the name to Tess. Let's check the name. And that's answer Tess. So the name already changed to Tess. Now I will give the name back to milliamp.com. Sometimes you got some weird character at the end of your Bluetooth name. So I will type 80 plus name milliamp.com then space. In your phone, you need to pair your Bluetooth module with your phone. Go to your Bluetooth settings, then look for available devices. There should read your Bluetooth name. For me, that is milliamp.com. Click the device name and input your pin. We already knew that the pin is 1, 2, 3, 4. Now, the Bluetooth module is successfully paired. After the pairing is done, you can download the app to test the communication. I often use app called Serial Bluetooth Terminal. You can download this app from the Play Store on your phone. Click the Bluetooth name. Once it connected, you can start send data to your Bluetooth module. You can see when I type test and send, the serial monitor receives the tag. And also when I send other tags, they will be printed on my serial monitor. So this proves that our Bluetooth communication from phone to Arduino has worked correctly. Now, how if we want to display the tag that's sent from the phone to an LCD? Let's hook up an LCD to our circuit. I use the LCD with I2C backpack, so it just connects the VCC to 5V, ground to ground, SDA to A4, and SCL to A5 of Arduino. Let's back to Arduino IDE, and this is the sketch to display the tag from my phone to LCD. So I include the library for LCD, and then I declare my LCD at 0627, and then I init the LCD, and I make variable for data. So I read the data from Bluetooth, and then I remove the 2 character at the end of data, because sometimes you got the weird character at the end of the data, and then I print the data on serial monitor and the data to the LCD. Wait, before we continue the video, you can make me really happy by subscribing to this channel and tap the bell so you won't miss new video from me. Okay, we have successfully displayed the tag from my Android device to LCD. Now, how if we want to control something with Arduino from my phone? So, I will try to control three LEDs, so we can turn on and off the LED using my phone. Take a look at this wiring diagram. So, the LED will be connected to pin 5, 6, 7, with 330 ohms resistor, and the other pins are connected to the ground. Let's do the wiring. So, I set 3 pins that connected to LED as an output, and then I save the data to char, and if the data is equals to 1, I will toggle the digital pin 5. So, pin 5 will high if it's low and will low if it's high. It's called toggle. And then if 2, I will toggle the pin 6, and if 3, I will toggle the pin 7. And of course, you can download or copy the sketch from the link in the description below. And don't forget to ground the jumper. Now, if I send 1 to Arduino, it will toggle the first LED. And 2 will toggle the second LED, and 3 the third LED. I turn off the lamp to see clearly the LEDs. And don't forget, the serial communication between the phone and Arduino is bidirectional. So, we can also send stack from my serial monitor to my Android device. So, I think this is the end of tutorial on how to use Bluetooth module with Arduino. Don't forget to subscribe and share to your friends to encourage me to make more videos. Thank you.